Today we're answering a viewer question because Darren S. asks us, why does standing in one place for a long time make my legs and feet sorer than walking for the same amount of time? Working retail, waiting table, standing in line at the amusement park, or just shopping with mum, anyone who's ever been stuck on their feet for a long time, more or less standing still, knows that it's much more tiring than walking for the equivalent amount of time. But why? First of all, when you stand, your legs aren't resting even beyond just supporting your own weight. Instead, your body sways very slightly. To keep you upright, a few muscles, particularly those in your calves, are constantly working, making very small adjustments that you probably aren't consciously aware of. On the other hand, when you walk, the burden is distributed across more muscle groups. Muscles swinging the arms help propel them, core muscles keep you stable, butt muscles complete your stride, and in the legs, both the calves and the thighs are employed. Second, when you're standing still, each foot and leg supports about half the body's weight, but neither ever gets a rest. On the other hand, when walking, each time a foot is raised, the muscles formally helping to balance you get a little break, as does the bottom of your foot. While only a small break in each instance, this totals about half the time being in more or less a resting state, other than the muscles required to lift your foot off the ground. Third, when you stand, the blood and lymph fluids pool in your feet, calves, and ankles because your heart cannot efficiently pump the blood all the way up from the feet by itself. This is why, if you stand in one place for long periods, you might notice that your feet and lower legs swell a little. Because the heart isn't up to performing this task efficiently, it relies in part on muscular contractions that occur when you walk and when you move about. As David J. Tibbs in Varicose Veins and Related Disorders states, only the peripheral pumping mechanism, musculovenous pumping, can cause full venous flow against gravity. This forceful pumping action is brought about when multiple veins are compressed by contraction of surrounding skeletal muscle. The valves direct the blood heartwards and prevent it from falling back again. Thus, by simple arrangements, the harder the muscles work, the more vigorous is the massive flow of blood generated by this activity returned towards the heart. Thus, when you stand in one place, your muscles are receiving less oxygen and other such things that they need to operate at peak efficiency compared to when you walk around. Fourth, when you're just standing, the entire load of your body rests on the same place, the underside of your feet, and particularly on the balls and the heels. Beyond one side getting the aforementioned break about half the time, when you walk, different parts of your feet bear the load at different times. Fifth, standing is sometimes much more boring than walking, particularly if you are at work with nothing mentally engaging to do, or, you know, you're watching your mother shop. With nothing to occupy your mind, it can wander to how tired you are and how much your feet hurt. On the other hand, when walking, the brain will be more occupied, since you must constantly assess the situation and avoid obstacles. Thus, standing may also seem even more tiring because you're just more aware of how your legs and feet are feeling. Sixth, if you walk fast enough or jog, your body will release neurochemicals that make you feel better, including adrenaline that pumps the heart faster, providing more oxygen to the muscles and brain. It also provides endorphins that will improve your mood. And now for a bonus fact. As with standing, any time a person remains upright, venous pooling will occur. In some situations, such as when a construction worker remains suspended in a fall harness, the device that saves his life after a fall, but is unable to move his legs significantly, the pooling of blood can reach a critical level. As more blood pools in the legs, which aren't moving enough to send it back up to the heart rate increases at first, and then will slow significantly. Without sufficient blood to bring fresh oxygen to the brain, the victim first loses consciousness. And if left in that condition, renal failure and even death can occur. If you want to know more about this morbid subject, how about you have a Google for suspension trauma? So, I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. And if you're looking for something else, why not check out some videos linked to on the screen or listen to our podcast? You can find that by searching BrainFood, one word, in, well, wherever you get your podcasts. And as always, thank you for watching.